Hey guys, in this video I'm going to talk about factorising algebraic expressions. So what is factorising? Well, that's to break something into its factors. So if you have a number like, say, 55 for example, if you were to factorise 55, you would break it into, say, think of two factors like 5 times 11. So you've just factorised 55 into 5 times 11, or you could have 1 times 55. And that's 55 factorised. That's actually all of the factors of 55. You can also factorise algebraic terms. So if you have like 3x, well, factors of 3x are 3 and x, so 3 times x. So that's factorising numbers and terms. And then if you have an expression, well, you need to take out the highest common factor. So let's have a look at an example. So let's say we have 3 lots of x plus 15. And I need to factorise that expression. So I need to take out the highest common factor. So let's look at 3x. Let's factorise that. Oops. So 3x equals 3 times x. And then if I factorise 15, well, this can be 1 times 15, or it can be 3 times 5. So let's have a look at the factors of 15 there. 1, 3, 5, and 15. So now, is there a common factor there? Yes, it's the 3. So that is actually the highest common factor. And I need to take that out of this expression. And what do I mean by take that out? Well, take it out of each term, or divide each term by 3. So what I do with that term, that common factor, is I put it out the front of the expression. And then inside the brackets, I need to put some brackets. I put the rest of the expression in those brackets. So if I've taken the 3 out of the 3x, or divide that by 3, I'm left with x. And then if I divide 15 by 3, you're left with 5. So that's that expression factorized. I've taken out the highest common factor. This is useful when you're dealing with fractions and longer terms and equations, where it might be easier to factorize and then do some cancelling, or get rid of some things to simplify an expression. So we need to get the hang of this before we move on to more complicated questions. All right, let's have a look at some more examples. Okay, so you can have all different types of expressions that you can factorise. So you might have lots of unknowns. So you might have 6ab, for example, minus a squared b. And then you need to factorise that. So let's have a look. The factors, so the factors of 6ab, well, that's going to be 6 times a times b, and then a squared b is going to be a times b. So can you see any common factors in there? Well, we've got an a here, and an a here, and we've got a b here, and a b here. So the highest common factor is actually a combination of a and b, so that's going to be a. Whoops, didn't mean to put that times. So the highest common factor is actually AB. And then we need to take what goes in the brackets is what's left over in each term. So 6AB, if we divide that by AB, we're just left with 6. And I've got a negative. And then if we take AB out of A squared B, all I'm left with is A. Okay, so. And then you can always double check. You can expand it back out to make sure you get the same thing. So 6ab, 6 times ab is ab. And then ab times a is a squared b. So you should end up with what you started with. So that's kind of a way to double check that you got the right answer. All right. Okay, let's have a look at another example. So you could have something that looks like this PQR. So for example, you might not have any numbers at all. You could just have lots and lots of letters, and you need to decide which letters are the common factors. So this looks a bit, you know, a bit nasty, lots of different letters, but actually all you really need to do is look for the letters that are common in each term. So no P's in here, so there can't be. I see a Q and a Q, so the Q must be a common factor, and then an R and no R there, so the only common factor there must be Q. So put the Q out the front, and in brackets it's the letters that are left over. So PR, and then plus, if I've taken out Q, I'm left with an RT, and then negative SW. All right, so that's the factorization of that expression. Let's just do a couple more. So let's do 25p squared, for example, minus 10p. So now, factors of 25p. Now you need to start, possibly, you can either write down all the factors, or perhaps you can do some work out in your head here and think what's common between 25 and 10. So I know that 5 goes into 25 and 5 goes into 10, but we need the highest. Is there a higher one? I'm not sure. So I think it might be 5 that is common, the highest common factor between 25 and 10. And then there's a p squared and a p. So actually, so p is in both. So it's going to be 5. P is the common factor. And then if you divide 25 by 5, you're left with 5. And then take out a p, you've got 1p left. And then minus 10p divided by 5p, well, all you're left with is 2. So 10p, cancel the p's and cancel the 5, and you're left with 2 there. Okay, so hopefully this is all making sense. And then just one more example, something, let's say, I don't know, you could have higher indices, so you might have something like 6p to the power of 4 minus 12p. So don't be too afraid of these indices. All that's saying is that's 4 lots of p times p times p times p. Okay, so I know the common factor between 6 and 12, or 6 goes into 12 twice, so 6 is the highest common factor there. And then I've got a p and a p, so 6p is the highest common factor. And then if I take 6p out of 6p to the power of 4, remember that's just p to the power of 4, not 6 to the power of 4 as well. So I've got p to the power of 3 left, and then minus 2, 12 divided by 6 is 2, and the p is in the common factor. So that's the factorization of that term, 6p bracket p to the 3 minus 2. Okay, so that's a few examples of factorizing algebraic expressions. Please let me know if there's any details I missed, or you need me to go over something that didn't make sense. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Bye.